Hello, welcome to Joy Everlasting. Thank you for subscribing to my channel. If you are subscribed, feel free to subscribe. If not, hit the notification bell. You could also hit a like, you can comment, whichever, or you could just tune in whenever you want. Anywho, today I kind of wanted to talk about King Joash, and his story is found in 2 Kings chapter 11 and 12, also in 2 Chronicles chapter 22, 23, and 24. He has a lot of information in here about this guy, but today I want to talk about choices, and I'm going to just pick up the story really quickly because he was a grandson of Jezebel, and his grandmother, Queen Athaliah, took over the kingdom when her son had passed away, and she was killing like the rest of the family. His aunt Jehosheba rescued him. I mean, you talk about a cool story. You think movies are cool? The Word of God is cool. Seriously cool. I mean, it's like so much drama. I mean, they could actually make it into a movie. But anyways, so Jehosheba, his aunt, rescues him. He's an infant boy. She is married to Jehoiada, who's a priest, who hid him in the temple. And I'm going to read right here in 2 Kings chapter 11, verse 3. It says, Joash remained hidden in the temple for 6 years while Athaliah ruled the land. So he was hidden. Crazy part about it is that Jehoiada had army commanders protecting the temple, protecting the front gate, protecting behind the temple. I mean, he felt like he had a responsibility to protect this little baby because he knew that that's who God had in the line of, you know, keeping the line of King David's lineage. But I want to talk about Joash here. So here in verse 12, it says, Jehoiada brought out Joash, the king's son, and placed a crown on his head and presented him with a copy of God's law. Here he was presented with the Bible, amen, which at that time. And it says, and they anointed him and proclaimed him king, and everyone clapped their hands and shouted, long live the king. They were excited because, you know, they took out Queen Athaliah, they killed her outside of the temple. I'm telling you, the story is exciting. It's a lot of cool stuff. But right here, King Joash was 6 years old, 7 years old, and he was anointed king, and he was provided God's laws. And when I first got saved, it was, I don't know if you know, my dad, Pastor Benny, he knows the Word of God, and he will quote it by heart, like, do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And I had this fear, like, I don't know, it was like early on when I got saved, and I thought of like the Holocaust, and I think I went to one of those museums, and I felt in my heart, like, man, what happens if I get taken away from my parents? And what happens if I'm like all by myself in a concentration camp? And I mean, my mind was crazy. Anyways, but I was just thinking, like, what happens if I don't even have the Bible and it's only what I have inside of me and only those, you know, stories that I had in, you know, children's church, you know, weird. Anyways, but I felt like wanting to know God's law, God's word. And I began to read it for myself because I felt like, what if something did happen? And what if whatever I had inside of me is all I had to give? So I felt that responsibility. And right here, Joash is presented with God's laws. And he did some good. I mean, he created the collection box to restore the temple. He did, you know, he tore down some things, the idols and stuff. But everything that he was doing was because his uncle was sharing with him. I don't know if it was like a sense of gratitude, like I need to, you know, do what, you know, my uncle Jehoiada is doing. Because, I mean, obviously, like, he's kind of like my dad, because, you know, obviously his dad died. I don't know what it was, but the part that I want to bring out is at the end of Jehoiada's life. I mean, the cool thing is Jehoiada got to live to 130, and if you know the Bible, the Lord after the flood cut off, you know, living time to 120. Well, this guy, he got to live long, and I think that God let him live long for, you know, Joash's case. But right here, in when he dies, it's in 2 Kings, it's actually 2 Chronicles chapter 24. It says this, in verse 17, it says, but after Jehoiada's death, the leaders of Judah came and bowed to the king Joash and persuaded him to listen to their advice. And he decided to abandon the temple of the Lord. And it goes on and it talks about his choice. And that he turned his back on God. And the crazy thing is that throughout all of his uncle's lifetime, he was good. Like, he was like on point. And he did what his uncle had asked him. And even with the 10 years extra that his uncle was given in life, it didn't even matter because Joash had an opportunity to have his own experience with God, and he didn't. He had God's laws. He had access to not only the man of God to learn, but when the opportunity came for him to choose between what he was going to do, he chose wrong. And then trip out on this, dude. This is what's scary. He was presented with, okay, so I'm going to read in verse 20. It's in 2 Chronicles chapter 24. It says, the Spirit of the Lord came upon Zechariah. He's a priest, and he basically tells him, this is what the Lord said. Why do you disobey the Lord's commands and keep yourself from prospering? You have abandoned the Lord, and now he has abandoned you. And the crazy thing about it is, if you read, I'm going to read it to you. It says, then the leaders plotted to kill Zechariah, and King Joash ordered them to stone him to death in the courtyard of the Lord's temple. I'm like, oh my God. I just think, like, in Joshua's days, it's actually the scripture I have behind me in Joshua chapter 24:15. Joshua says, if it seems evil for you to serve the Lord, choose you this day who you will serve, either the Lord or the God on the other side of the river. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And I just think, like, we're always presented with a choice whether or not we're going to choose to obey God's law or we're not. And he was persuaded. And if you read the rest of his life, he was killed. King Joash was killed and assassinated by these guys that were giving him the advice to kill the man of God. Now, mind you, they're the ones that take him out. They, like, take him out. And I just think, like, man, sometimes we, you know, disrespect our parents or disrespect the man of God. For what? For people that will take us out if it came down to it? You know, it's not worth it. And the only truth that is standing is the word of God, is God's word. And I just pray and hope that you decide to choose life. You know, even when you read in Moses' day, he kind of says, I have before you blessing and cursing. Choose blessing. I have here, you know, death and life. Choose life. You know, choose the Lord. You know, choose to obey God's law. He was presented with God's word, and yet he didn't choose it. He chose to be persuaded. And it reminded me of King Solomon's son, Rehoboam. He was also persuaded by, you know, wrong advice. And many times we ourselves can find ourselves being persuaded, you know, when we listen to advice that's not biblical, that's not godly. Anytime something comes your way, surface it through God's word. Ask yourself, is this line up with what the scriptures say? Does this line up with what God is saying? Does this line up with what my pastor is saying? You know, and if not, you know, reject it, because you could find yourself where it's only you, and you have to make a choice for yourself. Because the cool thing with King Joash, he was cool in the beginning because he had put in work and God spared him and all these cool things. But for what? For what? To be, you know, murdered by your own friends who you chose over God's people and caused you to even kill a man of God? You know, you think about it, it's like we may not actually assassin somebody, like, physically, but with our words, you know, criticizing, and or even not even standing up against when people are saying bad things about the man of God or anything godly. You know, when you just stay quiet, you're like agreeing, you know. And that's why he was easily persuaded, and then he ordered the hit. You know, it's crazy. But I just encourage you to know God's word, to read God's word, and these stories are here to help us so that we can learn. Like my dad says, it's good to learn from your own mistakes, but it's a lot wiser and a lot less painful if you learn from others' mistakes. And I believe that that's what the word of God does. It teaches us how to make a right choice, and teaches us to know that, you know, we want to choose the Lord. And I just pray that you choose Jesus, you choose to read the scriptures for yourself, and I pray and hope that you desire to know more about God, and that we don't make the same mistake that King Joash did. And if you're a Jehida and you're there and called to nurture and teach a young person, give it your all, just like Jehida did. He gave it his all, you know, and he poured everything that he could to him. And don't be discouraged, even if, you know, they may make a wrong choice or not. Just give it to them. You know, God has given you that responsibility. The way that Jehida did, he protected the king from an infant. He took his responsibility all the way till his dying day at 130. He did everything that he could to give out to this generation, to give out to those underneath him. And so I just pray that you're blessed, and I hope you have a great day. And know this, say no to sin, and never tell the Lord no. God bless you.